Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from Inkno. Can any of you guys tell me why the sky is blue? Nope. Well, we see this happen in classrooms way more often than we would like. To fix this, you can use the Pick-a-Name feature in ClassPoint. With this feature, you can randomly and easily choose a student to be called on. By the end of this video, you will know three different ways to implement it into your classroom to get your students talking and keep them engaged. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already to stay updated on all the different tech tips and ClassPoint tutorials that we have for you. Before we get started, I do want to mention a couple of the Pick-a-Name benefits. So first off, it helps you to choose students randomly and fairly to answer your questions. You don't have to worry about choosing favorites or hurting anyone's feelings. Secondly, it keeps students on their toes. They never know when they might be called on to answer a question. And then lastly, it helps you keep track of who has participated and who hasn't. So let's get started and see what this feature looks like with use case number one. The first way to use Pick-a-Name is to use it to randomly call on your students. I have a slide deck pulled up here, and I want to ask my students about their definition of camouflage. I know that if I ask them this out loud, I won't have a whole bunch of hands raised and willing participants. So if I'm in my presentation mode, on the ClassPoint toolbar, I can use the Pick-a-Name feature. So it's this one almost at the end with the little guy raising his hand. So when I click on that, you'll see that a whole bunch of boxes appear on screen. So this actually has your students' names behind the boxes. When I click on a name, it will reveal who can answer the question. So you can actually use this throughout your whole presentation. So if I exit this and change slides and open it back up again, you'll see that the name that has already been clicked is still there, and I can click on another one if I want. The second way to use the Pick-a-Name feature is to use it to help you group your students or separate them into breakout groups randomly. So I have an activity that I want my students to collaborate on. So I'm going to use the Pick-a-Name feature to help separate them into groups. So if you already have used this feature before and some names are revealed, you can always go ahead and reset it, and we'll put all the students' names back behind the boxes in a different place. So for this activity, I'm just going to go in a diagonal line and click on four students, and that will be my first group. So you can go ahead and do that in any way that you want for as many students that need to go in a group. You can write them down or just have students get into their groups right away. The third way to use the Pick-a-Name feature is to use it to assign different tasks to your students. So you can do this all on its own for maybe classroom activities, or you can use it in conjunction with example number two. So we had previously split up our students into groups with the Pick-a-Name, so now we can use the same way to assign different tasks to them. So we can assign different tasks per each column since everyone in that column is in a different group. So let's say you could use it to have a scribe for the group. The second column could be the timekeeper, and you could have other columns for other activities that you want them to work on. Thank you so much for following along on our three different use cases for using Pick-a-Name in your classroom. If you want to learn more, you can watch our tutorial video that's linked in the description below or up top. If you have any other ways that you use Pick-a-Name in your classroom, we would love to hear about it. Don't forget to hit subscribe and stay updated. And if you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up.